pretty excited about this first speaker, and I think you're really excited about our first speaker. So why don't you introduce Paula?
Yes, thank you so much, Ann. For those of you who don't know, Paula Gold-Williams, the president and CEO of CPS Energy, has played a big part of the ETS story. She was actually our 2018 Thought Leader of the Year. Probably one of the most significant forces driving the voice of change in the industry, and also leading the nation's largest municipal electric utility. She just happens to be a great partner and friend, and the whole CPS Energy team and their partners around them have really given us a voice that it really challenged us as well throughout our partnership to do things differently and to think differently and to think big and to think bold. And that's what ETS is about. And so it gives me great pleasure to introduce Paula Gold-Williams as the first keynote speaker of ETS19.
Monday, we're here at an energy conference. I got to have you hear my voice. Thank you. I have so many thank yous. Of course, thanks to Austin, because the Energy Thought Summit originated here, and Z Prime is right up the road from us. So I've been coming to Austin for decades. When I was thinking about my comment, I said something like, you know, I should tell them I've been coming up here for decades and decades, but I figured that made me sound too old, so I'll just say decades. Love Austin. I am unapologetically, though, a big San Antonio girl. Born and raised, love San Antonio. We're in the taco wars with Austin. It's a thing we got. But I want to talk to you about a lot of things in a small amount of time, and I will be talking about the anchor that we have between our two communities, Austin and San Antonio, and how we kind of, where we are today and where we think we're going. Again, though, I think really critical to our opportunity has been Z Prime. Thinking about thought leadership, thinking about how to bring an attractive discussion to the industry, to the energy sexy. When I joined about 15 years ago, there was not anything really sexy. I thought it was sexy, but I realized not everybody else did. I can look at energy infrastructure today and I think it looks awesome. I think, you know, we have certain infrastructure around lakes and water and all that kind of stuff, and I think and trees, and I think it looks great. But I do understand that, again, I am biased unapologetically. And Z Prime realized long ago that there's an opportunity here to create synergies, create dialogue, because innovation is already happening. They could see it happening then. We could see it happening over a decade ago. We are very diversified in San Antonio. Don't judge me. I'm proud of it, but we have energy that we can produce from nuclear, from gas, from coal. We're reducing our perspectives and goal, our ownership of coal, but we actually have the last coal unit with all the environmental controls on it. We use ultra-low sulfur coal. And, you know, it's in the system and it's helping with reliability. But we have a huge portfolio of wind. We're number one in solar in San Antonio. And we continue to invest in energy storage because diversification is the key to our future. So I came up here about 4 years ago and I saw what Z Prime was, and I saw what the potential was, and I said, hey, there's more here. The way that Jason and Mark are able to create something organically as friends and then bring in bigger and bigger discussions, create all these great emails that we got. And I do have to give a special shout out to Ricky. Where is Ricky? Did he leave me? Ah, Ricky. He knew 4 years ago I had no idea what Z Prime was, And he showed me all the ropes and how to really optimize my experience here. So in all honesty, I walk up to Jason and I said, hey, you're going to be my good friend. And we're going to create this connection between San Antonio and Austin. I think you should do some forum there. You should partner with me. And he kind of looked at me like I was a crazy lady. This lady from San Antonio talking about all the things he should do more broadly with San Antonio. And so, that said, I was undaunted and I decided that I needed to get started. I could feel the energy, that's a pun, the energy changing around me. And I became CEO about 3.5 years ago. And we created our own conference, Energy of the Future SA. It was our own, we enjoyed it. We didn't invite anybody really from the industry. We invited local San Antonians. We invited civic leaders, educators, business people, students, because we wanted to engage them in a discussion about how different energy can be. And we run a municipal entity. Our municipal entity, we get to manage the assets that the community owns. And we wanted our community to understand things are going to change, and they're changing, and we're making them change. But customers have to help us make the right decisions. So I'll tell you a little story about that. We had half a day, nothing like this. We're going to be really good friends by the end of the conference, but we had about a half a day, and one of my good friends who's not in the industry, marketing, communications person, walks into me. I even feed him. I have lunch. And I feed him, but he sits at the table and he says, Paula, you can't possibly talk about energy for more than an hour. Funny here, right? But the average citizen doesn't really think about energy that much. And I said, of course, I talk about energy 24/7, 365. And I want you to care enough about knowing about what energy is doing. Because again, these are your assets. We're trying to make sure that you understand what your utility does for you, the decisions that we make, the complicated views that we have on the future. And you have to be careful because if you're really not having an appetite for it, your friend's eyes can gloss over in about 15 minutes of discussion. But we got through that discussion. We spent 4 hours, we did it again. We first did it at St. Mary's University, my alma mater. Then we moved on to A&M University, both of them half a day. But I kept all the time talking to Z-Prime, talking to Jason, hey, we need to do something in San Antonio. And lo and behold, after we had optimized our portfolio, we decided to close down two coal units. We had arguably the biggest energy efficiency and conservation program in Texas. We had a mega release of solar, 400 megawatts, and that back in 2012, that was a huge amount of megawatts. And we had all these things going for us. We also created this thing called the Flexible Path. I'm just going to say it and not explain it because I'd have to have all day to talk about it. But ultimately, we've done all those things, and I am beyond humble that Z-Prime and the constituency that follows allow me to become the Energy Thought Leader. And I can't tell you how much that means, but basically, what it really does mean is that our 3,000 employees that run our system are doing a fabulous job of doing great work today and moving the industry forward, and I got the opportunity to be a thought leader to represent what's happening at CPS Energy. But then I thought, so what? It's great, I appreciate it, I'm gonna pass the baton, but we gotta keep going because we're really at the foothill of change. We're not done, we're not even anywhere near done of all the good stuff that's gonna come across. And so I wanted my 1 year to mean something. So right after being able to be at the conference and do it, I just took off and our organization took off. And we started saying to ourselves, we've got some great foundational moves. We believe in people first. We believe that it is the nexus point of customers as our beacon, understanding how to look at your community, where the opportunities are to meet them, and ultimately reinvesting in your employees. Yes, we need to replace employees over time, but we'll be well served by being smart about it. We have energy experts that are going to help us convert from how we did things to the future. So that business trinity was really important. And we also thought about, what do? We provide power. And we are not the absolute innovators. We're innovative, and we can aggregate value. We can partner, and we have to, because it is partnership that will give us the best leverage. But our job is 24/7, 365 to run an energy company. And so we thought about, we provide the power to dream. That is our thing. If we provide power, then businesses can innovate. Then businesses can grow. Families can thrive. Schools can educate. That's what we do. So we have those foundations, and then what? We thought, we could focus on San Antonio only and just kind of slog it out and kind of narrow our perspective and say, oh, we're the energy thought leaders, and just move on slowly. But we actually believe the energy industry is moving fast. We're just in it, so you can't feel it, but it's moving. So we thought we needed to take advantage of everything that was in front of us. Last year, me and multiple people across our organization, we got out. I like to say this. Went to Las Vegas, Mexico. Went to Toronto, went to Amsterdam, we invited back in Germany, went to South Korea, we went to Japan, California. California's kind of a country of its own. I mean it lovingly. And what we realized is that we have to immerse ourselves in looking across the globe for solutions, and also looking to our partners. We have to think global and apply local. We have to really be students of this industry. We have to be in learning mode. We have to relearn what we thought was going to get us through the rest of our careers and realize it's not good enough, and that we've got to change. And we have to again and again and again optimize partnership. Z Prime is a great partner. We've also created partnerships and created a new energy economy where we can invite and have invited businesses from around the globe to come to San Antonio to bring their technology, to bring their innovation, to bring their efforts to build in an economy of new energy. And in fact, I think where we really are today is about that strike. And before I know it, Vikram, are you here? Yasser, it's another aspect. Our existing partnerships are great, but what we love are new companies trying to get going. And I want to give a shout out, because we started a C3. It's focused on customers. Customer-centric competition is what it is. It's all of that to the third power. And through that, we found Yada Solar. They came and competed at our very first tech-like outreach. And what I loved about it is we planted in 30 days, executed it, and found these great companies that were willing to share their knowledge, and companies that were looking to do new pilots. We did a pilot with Yada. That's a company to watch. But we also launched technology and innovation inside our company. We did a C3E. Customer-centric competition for employees. The point is, we got lots of good ideas from employees. Again, this industry has a tendency to let you keep doing the same thing. You can become an expert. 20 years, 30 years, a career in this industry. But right now, what we really want to do is get people doing their good job, 24/7, 365, but if they have ideas, supporting those ideas, and creating new partnerships, and figuring out exactly how we can all work together, not just as a local community or a corridor, but as a state, as a nation, and as a globe. Why I think that's really important, as I sat down with the CEO, Dr. Marie Louise Wolf. She is the head of Integra Energy in Darmstadt, Germany, and her English is 1,000 times better than my German. thank God. But we sat down and we talked about what's going on in the industry. The problems we have in San Antonio are the same problems they have in Germany. They're no different. They have concerns for their community and their customers. They have concerns because they're looking for technology to catch up with customer preferences. And they're trying to solve that inside of their communities, taking into consideration of the environmental issues, affordability, reliability, innovation, the speed of it, or the lack of speed of it. All the things that we have to do. And so it was great. It was great to share. And we have different momentums and we have different push points, but we're all looking at the same solutions. We're all trying to figure out how do we bring it all together. And I think it's really important to be at places like this, at ETS, where we can share and be in a room and make connections and try to help each other solve problems. And by far, we want to make sure that we do bring quite a few solutions, as many as we can, to the core. I believe that between the San Antonio and Austin corridor in particular, because we're both Jackie Sargent and I, she runs the energy company here, we are focused on a lot of the same things with a lot of the same similarities. And then we've got public power all up and down this corridor. And the point is, if we can create more synergies and optimize our partnerships and work together and take advantage of all the things that we learn when we come to places like this and be available, we think we can implement some of the most innovative and hopeful pilots and then aggregations. And the point again would be to attract people to do that, to get the conversations going, to get the community involved, and understand it's not going to be an easy road. And understand that we are in the land and the room of the converted. Not everybody's converted. However, I will end with this. I tell everybody that I have the privilege and the honor to be in this industry. I have the privilege and honor to lead our 3,000 wonderful employees every single day. But again, the spectrum of who we serve is wide. The beliefs that they have are wide. The solutions that they think are the best solutions, the emotions underneath them are deep. Unfortunately, I think oftentimes there is more division right now than there is collaboration, but I am hopeful. I am extremely hopeful. We don't give up. We've got to change. If not, change will happen to us. And as a utility company, I'm here to tell you, we're not stuck. We want to be right there supporting technology and innovation along the way, because we believe electrons and molecules love everyone. They don't decide. They don't go to some homes or some parts of the city or only choose to put them in at a certain time. They go where they're needed. They go where the inertia tells them. We're energy experts. We control it. We keep it safe. We secure it. We make sure that when you need it, it is there. And that is the love of the industry. That is the love of being able to provide reliable power that enables lives and powers dreams. So with all of that, I'm glad to be here to kick off this event. I will be with you this week, and I will be with you, I hope, for at least another decade to come. So thank you for your time. Thank you so much.